Good morning, on Thursday, August the 5th. Some time ago I decided I would do a reflection on names. And then Jane Jolly announced that her reflection was What's in a Name? And I thought, oh dear, that's put pate to mine. However, what she said did not impinge upon my thoughts at all. So here goes. When I lived in Nidderdale, a family in one of the villages asked the minister to do a naming ceremony for their new baby, rather than a baptism. I was down to preach on that day, so when the ceremony was finished and the minister left, I took over. My sermon was on the theme of names. I began by telling them about the meaning of my name. Eileen means light, and Mary means bitter. A great guffaw went up from the visitors, but not being a frequenter of pubs, I didn't at first realise the connection with ale and beer, light and bitter. The meaning of names is important. Surnames in the past had a lot to do with what a person did or where he lived. And in Wales, where I grew up, because many surnames were duplicated, we referred to Jones the Butcher, or Evans the Milk, or Morgan the Builder, or William the Fish, etc. And in those days, Christian names were hardly used. Names are very important, as are their meanings. In the Bible, I can't think of any surnames that were used, although a title might be given, priest or prophet or king perhaps. The first name we come across after God is Adam, which comes from the Hebrew word Adama, meaning ground. Samuel means heard of God. Hannah gave him that name because God had heard her impassioned plea for a child. Esau means hairy, and Jacob, he who grasps the heel. Remember the story of their birth. Jacob's name was changed after his struggle with the angel. His name was changed to Israel, which means he who wrestles. Abraham means the father of many, which he was, and Sarah means princess. It's interesting to notice that when God renamed them, an H was inserted, just as if the Holy Spirit had breathed into them. Isaac means he laughs. Remember how they laughed when the angel said they would have a child in their old age? Other examples of renaming, this time in the New Testament, are Jesus renaming Simon as Peter, meaning the rock, and Saul being renamed Paul. These renamings happened at significant places in their lives. God is given many different names. When Moses asked God for his name at the burning bush, Yahweh was the answer, which means I am who I am. A name describing his eternal power and his unchangeable character. The names El Shaddai and Adonai reflect God's almighty power too. Jesus gives himself many titles. The bread of life, the shepherd, the gate or door, the vine, the Son of Man, the resurrection and the life. And we know him as the Prince of Peace, the light of the world, and of course the Son of God. He is the name above all other names, the Messiah, the Anointed One, the Christ. And believers were first called Christians at Antioch. God said we must not take the name of the Lord in vain. Sadly, many people use the names of God and Jesus as expletives. I once read about a Christian who, when he heard someone use the names in that way, said, "Oh, you know him too," which might have stopped them in their tracks and made them think twice next time. Maybe it even started a conversation about faith. So let's pray. Loving Lord, your name is precious to us in all its meanings. Forgive us if we ever use it in unrespectful ways. Help us to tell others what your names mean to us. Help us to be proud of being called Christian and to be a good example to others. Help us to live up to that name in the way we behave, our thoughts, our words, our deeds, our attitudes. And may we not be afraid of being laughed at for our belief in you as our Lord and Saviour. Amen.